Hello everybody and welcome to something I haven't been doing for a while now. It's been a while, but today I'm doing a replay cast. More specifically, I guess a self cast or something where I analyze my own games and see what I did well, what I didn't do well and stuff, and maybe hopefully learn something for the future. And yeah, the game I'm commentating today, or casting today, or watching today, whatever, is my game. First Fubuki, in the tournament, specifically the first one, we have in the top me with Imatris, starting with Forge here. And in the bottom we have Fubuki with Isengard. Right, and this is game one of the tournament match. In case you haven't watched the tournament, I'm gonna spoil it now. I lost 2-0, which is, you know, that's pretty. That's why I'm watching the replays now, also. Or why I was thought, yeah, these replays are interesting to watch. So, you know, that we maybe can see why I lost, or what I could have done better. Because I think I played fairly decent in those matches, or at least in this one. But in general, I would say in this current version, I'm not as experienced as I used to be. In general, in 4-5. But yeah, you can see. First of all, Fubuki is creeping the upper troll right away. This is interesting. Mina, you can see I just take the forge, Imbiss forge here. I'm not really bothering with one side. Because, so my thought process here, or my goal here was to get a pretty early base rush. And hopefully win. Or alternatively at least take some damage that, deal some damage that, you know, I can then build into like a pretty good position for myself. Because I was a bit scared against Isengard. I expected Isengard because of the way the bans were and the map pick. I banned Mordor and something else. I don't know what that's I banned. And I thought, yeah, Imatris might be a decent choice here. But of course, Isengard gets pretty scary in the late game, and that was what I was scared about. Especially with Imatris, although Imatris itself isn't too bad. But yeah, in the late game, I think. But once again, this is like, late game is where I'm definitely not on top of the game right now, really. I don't really know everything. But yeah. Yeah, like I said, I'm not voting with the top side, just saying, yeah, well, I'm probably not gonna. I don't want to get harassed here all over the place with Dunlands, so I'm not gonna. Not even gonna try to, and instead try to, you know, get the lower half and then walk into the base, I guess. And yeah, you can see my opponent, also Fubuki, is getting Dunlands. And so far, I have only this one Sword Battalion. But I'm gonna get some more soon. And you can see I'm also getting Cavalry Battalion early. That's why I got basically only focused on Eco at first, so I can get. Cavalry Battalion pretty easy, and yeah, my goal, once, this is against the Dunlands. Actually kind of forgot about this. It's been a while since these games have played, but yeah, this is basically to be safe against the Dunlands and also maybe have something against the Vorks. Probably should be on my playbook the whole time, so I can see if I, like, spend my money. So yeah, this is just gonna be one Battalion, and then the stable is gonna be removed again, because I don't really see the point of getting a second more than one Battalion at this point. I mean, Isengard pikes are pretty efficient at guarding against cavalry, and yeah, but they are here now. But yeah, I just didn't really expect anything out of my cavalry, at least not until they then later have upgrades. So just said, okay, one Battalion is enough. I'm not sure why I'm not riding up here, but I'm doing that now a bit late here. So I guess that's one minor thing. But now I'm getting swords out. And should probably start. Nice. Okay, actually, one more sword battalion, then I should probably start the upgrade. Ah, no, I'm starting now. Nice. Okay, I think it's fine at this point. And yeah, I see the Vorks. I'm pretty sure I've scouted the base. And this is where I definitely was a bit too bold with my swords. I mean. Multiple Imatris soldiers in like a clump, they are pretty safe against the Vorks because they have their build, if they have their ability active especially. But this one battalion here against that one Orc battalion might have died actually. I don't know, but I definitely was a bit too careless with my walk, soldiers. That's of course not easy here on this map, but I guess you could try to use the cavalry to keep them safe a bit. Yeah, you can see the cavalry took some scout arrows, but that's not really that big of a deal. You have to heal. I think that's fine. Yeah, just resting once again. Because I know, like, at this point he doesn't really have that much to counter my soldiers, except the Vorks. But if I keep them close to each other, then that's fine as well. But once again, this is pretty unsafe here. Yeah, he's actually creeping the Vorks with his Vorks. Okay, interesting. I feel like that's a bit of a waste of like, cavalry at this point, but I'm not sure. Because, like I said, I'm being a bit too overextended here. Actually, didn't know that it. I don't remember knowing at least that he has more than one bark battalion. I just thought he only had one going into the sea play. Okay, I think so far the money spending is alright. I mean, there isn't really that much happening. The cavalry did the damage. This is where mess up. This is where pretty big mess up happens. I try to walk creep the walks, but I'm not paying enough attention. You can see. My sword battalions do not focus the walk. Two of them are attacking the buildings. These ones are also not focusing the walks, and that's gonna cause me to essentially lose one battalion here. Which, you know, is a pretty big loss for Imitris, so that's definitely something that I should have avoided. And I'm definitely gonna look forward to the, like, base rush happening. And see, like, maybe it would have two more battalions have made a difference. Because I'm also gonna lose this one here. Actually, I think this one might just be will probably survive, but yeah, this one will definitely die. And once again, this is just me being way too bold against cavalry with swords. Without just one single battalion, it's just gonna lose against them. Maybe if the wind is there, but even with the wind. And then, yeah, that's way too late. Just basically a waste. Yeah, this was pretty stupid. And you can see, I mean, even if in melee, right, like, cavalry takes not much damage from swords. See, and this is where I get... Might be getting a bit too scared of cavalry, because there is no walk stable left. I open now at two barracks. Which is why, like, this is where maybe the base rush should have actually happened already. If I didn't lose this battalion, I had, like, four battalions, I could already run in. There's only one tower. Maybe not necessarily fully commit to it, but maybe get like something out of it. Maybe even just a farm. And force them to build towers and then maybe come back later. I don't know. I'm gonna get banner carrier soon. Relatively soon. But like taking losses as long as not more than one battalion is fine here. In fact, right here I could have actually run in even with just three battalions, I think. But I got a bit too scared from this one tower. Or at least, I guess, the second tower. And you can see, right, like, he doesn't protect his armory, which is a pretty big deal. Pretty big target, I mean. So yeah, that's a mistake, I think, right there. And generally, like I said, like, the thought here is to, like, get the damn... Keep Isengard just from getting too far in the, like, mid-game. Because this double barracks is pretty scary to me. At least of Imitris also, like, I'm not really sure. Hey, I'm actually running in here, interesting. I don't remember that. The question is, will I... Yeah, just having this one in it really annoys me. I had, like, this... some damage missing. Right, okay, this one... Okay, I'm not sure, let's look at this one. We have two battalions here of orcs, rooks, yeah, that are not that dangerous. I have a heal already. The orcs are annoying. There are two towers now, which are pretty dangerous, and I actually don't remember this one, like, at all. Yeah, no, this one was not worth it. I lose a level 3 battalion. The heal is there. I think maybe the towers just came up, that did too much damage. This is interesting. Because once again, I don't remember this. So I guess this one was a bad race rush. How to say. Yeah, this is where I get armor actually first, before the ban occurs apparently. I'm not sure if that really matters, because I guess armor is safer, especially if you have least lower amount of units and just have Tecmo fights. Now I'm getting rest, and I basically did no damage, so that's a good thing to like realize that I had this really bad base rush that did nothing. The Vorks did pretty good here, trampling my units, causing them not to have problems escaping. I guess I underestimated the towers here, maybe. So maybe I should have just waited for armor. Because if I had armor, I guess I could have gotten way better, and I wouldn't have like have these all these battalions, I lost any battalions and wouldn't have battalions that are one soldier and two soldiers. So basically also losing seven soldiers here until I have ban occurs, which will take a while. I mean, it's also extra cost, right? Like if I didn't, if I don't need to get ban occurs, that's obviously 600 plus, what is it? 160 per battalion, 150 per battalion with like five forges, okay. That I save on resources, so that's good to know. Some slight money build-up, maybe because of the armor, not really. I've probably got one more battalion here. I guess we'll see later if it's really worth it. No eco upgrades right now. This is basically just for never mind, I actually get in-base eco, interesting. Interesting, yeah, okay. Ooh, that's kinda bad, but they're gonna escape, I think. Oh, barely. I think they're gonna escape barely. But yeah, I basically lost the entire map here. I guess I got some of the upper side, but that's not really ideal. Especially these single sources also not ideal. Now I have armor. And just in general, I just quite a lot of immortal soldiers that I didn't have to lose. I think. Let's check out the CP. I'm actually ahead in CP. I got this armor really early. Let's see, he already has level 2 in-base echo. Now level 3. Actually it's faster than me in this, yeah, quite a bit. You see? Right, I'm on the wrong, that's why. Getting outside echo here. not sure if that's the right choice, but it's hard to say. I mean, I'm pretty sure I will get the outside economy after the base rush, which will be fairly successful, I think. But yeah. The Riders doing damage here, more or less. But they take time to damage. Takes some time. But right now, I'm not gonna commit anything for the Riders because it's like, yeah, he has spikes everywhere. That's already enough for me, I guess. But he just builds spikes. Has to build spikes. Not really, I mean, now that they have armor, I could try things with that. I'm moving them around always, I think. Not always, but I'm trying to move them close to the fight. It's actually where they. Right, we are also banner careers now. Yeah, so this is where they actually give me something here. They will get this battalion, I think. I think I noticed that. And now I'm running into the base. Yeah, and this could have just been a lot cleaner, I guess. The whole base rush thing. He's getting blades now, okay. Lutz is here. But yeah, I'm still ahead in CP. I have more armor, so now I guess the question could also be, do I really need the base damage? And I don't have any map control, but I guess I could probably, I mean, could fight pretty well for a while at least. But the thing is, I don't think it would really matter if I would take the map here. I mean, it would matter, but I'm not sure if it's like the time that spent taking that and maybe even getting some losses in the while. By doing that, maybe leveling Lords here a little bit. Ooh. Okay. Right, and meanwhile, the whole time Isengard can spam out of two barracks. Right, so eventually we'll probably be able to deal with everything. Ooh, Oakluck dies. That's very nice. Actually, so it's like, yeah, maybe the base rush wasn't necessary, but I feel way safer doing this than trying to win the map against Isengard when Isengard isn't really. I mean, Geisengard is certainly not fine, I guess, without the map for the most part. It's gonna be hard anyways to get the map even. Even if I have the armor right now. I mean, now he has blades. I think once again, like, this just wasn't a clean game for me, definitely. If this was way more cleaner, if I lost, didn't have that first fate base, or at least didn't lose this much, and didn't lose those two battalions in the early game, I would have just, I could have probably easily gone in the base earlier, when he didn't have blades. But yeah, this way I got Ugluk, I guess. I got some, I lost like around, what did I say, 800? Unfortunately, I didn't check how many battalions went in there. I wanted to count it actually, but I think it was maybe 8, maybe 9. I will get Lords here as well. And now a question, I guess, is was this worth it? And the answer is, and generally I would say, like, getting 2 heroes, that's quite a lot of money. The Riders will die here, I think. And I mean, it killed some Orcs, which is also some money. And they will run away now. Of course, I don't have the map. I'm not sure why these are fighting a tower. I guess they will destroy it. I guess I could... I guess one question here is, could I try to maybe even continue this with armor? I don't have a heal ready anymore. And I think the answer would be no. Because there are just too many towers, are just annoying. The orcs will... And then the orcs will fight, right? So this armory would have been a pretty priority target, a pretty high priority target, but unfortunately I didn't get it. I think I lost my cavalry battalion, yeah. No, never mind. But yeah, I get out with 4 battalions, I think, so probably around half of my swords, maybe in this. So that's... I mean, one sword battalion is 500, plus some armor. Plus 225 per armor, so it's like 725 per battalion, times 4, that's around 3,000, I guess. A bit less than 3,000. 2,900, I think. But in return, you get like Ugluk, Lords, some Orcs. And I think generally, I mean, and also set back the, I mean, getting the Orcs is not that insignificant right now. I have. No, it doesn't have as much to spread around. I guess I was in the CP lead before. And I mean, all this, I mean, 4 battalions getting out. I mean, that's not terrible. Also, the cavalry. I also got 1 barracks, I guess, and 1 tower. It's a little bit. But I guess generally this was kinda even. I think at that point, at where I lost the entire map, it probably would have been just, at that point, it was kinda committed to it. Maybe if I tried to defend the map, I would have actually won on the map, the way I played that. But I think at that point, like, I already lost most of the map. I was standing right here, I had my armor, I kinda got my upgrades early, more or less. I was kinda committed at that point, I would say. I mean, fighting the map for the map at that point, it's just gonna be way too hard against Isengard, probably. That's my guess, at least. But I mean, you could disagree there. 1,000 resources, not sure what I'm spending them on, maybe it's just upgrades. But also, I think, like, the base rush could have worked if I wouldn't have blundered so much in the early game. I mean, quite a lot, really. starting to get military studies eventually. Just to fight for the map. I'm still pretty happy here at this point, or I was pretty happy while I was playing this, I mean, for getting both Ugluk and Lords. Just so that they can't level. That's another thing, right? If I hadn't had the base rush, I probably wouldn't have killed them. At least not without the speed boost. And I am getting the map here. It's just, at this point, is it really a big deal? I don't know. That's just me, like, right, it's like I said in the early, when beginning to cast this, I don't know really how to play 4.5 in like 8 game generally. Not that used to it, especially not with Imatris. Or at least not with Imatris. And this is not a late game yet, sure, but it's starting to get there. But I don't want to get into the late game against Isengard, was basically my fort here. for the match, so, yeah. Let's see. No Imatris soldiers, no CP upgrade? No, it's coming. Heroes? Probably wouldn't have really done much here. I don't really think Imatris is a hero that's really worth it here, except maybe Curdan, which I'm getting eventually? I don't remember as well.
Not
sorry. Another question, I guess, is I think this fight is kind of winnable, right? Yeah, they just straight up win that. Another option would have been an outpost. Once again, this is one thing where I'm not really sure how much worth an outpost is if you don't get it for something specific. Like, usually when I get outposts, I get them because I want maybe like a specific building, and I don't really want, or maybe multiple specific buildings, and I don't want to sacrifice like my main base fortress for that. Right? Don't want to rip my economy too much. Instead, just getting it. Right, so that in the long term, it's gonna be payout eventually. Right, the speedos is here now, just to get fight better. Has armor here yet? No. In this point, it's not too bad, I think, right? Like, I mean, it's hard to say. But I am ahead, like, 300 CP. I have armor, I don't have blades, but he doesn't also have... He only has blades and no armor. I guess I might get blades soon, I think. Getting... No, I'm not getting Curdan, okay. It's hard to say, right? I have the map control. And that's something. But yeah, anyways, right? Like, maybe an outpost here, just get some fortress, some more economy. It's like, maybe that would have been worth it. Or maybe Dunland, right? Another thing, right? Less Dunland for Dunlands, or just the well and the tower, right? A Dunland can pretty much defend itself very much. It can defend itself to some degree. That's why Dunland is so sweet, so nice. We don't have to protect it as much as a normal outpost. I mean, at some point you need to protect it, but like... you don't have to protect it all the time. Against every... you don't have... Like, against smaller clumps of units, right? Whereas a normal outpost, you would need a tower to even, like, defend against... Like, one or two battalion of enemy soldiers. When you're fighting at the Dunland outpost, and right, and they have the well and stuff. Like, you only get one farm, of course, in the outpost income, but easier to defend. You don't have to spend a build blood for a well. So yeah, this fight is really good for me. And it's just kind of, right, like you can see, I'm ahead in CP so far, so much. I'm getting blades during this fight. I also have the speed boost ready eventually. I mean, I have the speed boost researched and it's gonna be ready again eventually. I have the arrogant blades, that's what you just get. Right, like if you get the speed boost and the arrogant blades, how do you say, you get them at the same time now. With the same upgrade. Are the cavalry doing work? And once again, it's like, would have multiple cavalry really done much here? I mean, you can probably just charge in here. Maybe. Speed boost, like maybe yes, maybe yes. But I don't really like Immortus cavalry against Isengard. I'm really, really doubtful, right? It can go very wrong, I think. Let's check back. But yeah, this fight was really good for me. Just got some fights. Although on the flip side, I didn't kill Lords. I did, unfortunately didn't catch the army. I guess I should have not chased the whole army with everything that was here. I should have split them up here. Gildor wasn't enough, right? If I had protected Gildor here, if I had split the army here, how do you like this? And then Gildor comes here. Look at this amazing draw function. Then I could have used Gildor's level 3 ability, like I did, which slows down units and gives allied units a speed boost, right? And then he wouldn't have died immediately because he would have been protected, so I actually could have used the speed boost. So then I maybe could have even dealt the damage, maybe could have killed Lutz. But here I'm just running into the base. And although the CP is still ahead and I have blades, I have better upgrades I think at this point. The crossbow is still hurt, the tower's hurt. And this is probably where this was a big mistake. Right, like this is when... okay, here you can see again, right? Like if I had my cavalry, maybe that would actually be worth it because now he has no pikes anymore. I only have one cavalry battalion without a speed boost, so that won't be dealing that much damage. And I already lost 300 CP. The barracks is really not that worth it, because you can just rebuild it pretty far easily. His levels are his heroes are leveling hard. I mean, I should have checked the hero level beforehand, but now he's lost his level 8. And he's actually gonna clean my entire army here. And this was a big mistake, which I now know. And I think generally this is just me once again, right? I've said it before. I don't really know that much. I'm not that great at the late game right now, at the mid game, it's related mid game, I guess. And a lot of it comes also down to like judging how strong your opponent is. And against Isengard, I am way too scared, I guess. Think right, I have to finish now. But I was ahead in CP. I could have probably like added to my army. I had a good fight there, which I could have done better. There's some here. But then I ran into base, died against the towers, died against the crossbows. Didn't have to carry, I guess. I guess carry is good. maybe I should have some more faith in carry again. Because that could have been really useful against the crossbowman. Crossbowman definitely did a lot of damage there. Obviously also lost on Dukluk, right? And I just thought I could do it here. I thought if I didn't do it, I would probably lose. But it was a big mistake, because I had a map. I could have just gotten outposts. I could have maybe gotten more cavalry. That would have been good idea. Curdon as a hero. Maybe even something like a stronger hero, like maybe the twins. I don't know how strong the twins are against. I mean, that hero killed us, but Lutz is also a hero killer and also more. So, Glorfindel maybe would have been decent. Because I had the money, I think, right? I had in CP, I had 1,000 CP of upgraded Immortus battalions. And now I'm screwed, by the way, right? Like, I lost everything. Except the cavalry battalion. No, I think even lost that at the point. And also now he has level 8 lords, level 9 Ukluk or something like that. Level 10 lords. Okay, maybe they're both level 10 already. I'm not gonna be able to fight that at all now. I spent the money that I saved up during the fight, during the base rush. Which also wasn't great, I guess. So yeah, someone in so Cowan streamed this. And someone in the comments of the YouTube upload said, man, Immortus really threw the first game hard. And I guess maybe he's right. Like, before watching this replay, I wasn't sure how good my position was. But I think, like, at that point, after this fight, that was here. Before the base rush, obviously. I could have done it. I could have probably just gotten an outpost. I wouldn't have too much trouble defending it. Maybe even get catapults early, right? Just to annoy. Because catapults are weak, but I mean, they don't deal that much damage at all. But it's still like they deal damage from afar, and you can just kind of annoy your enemy. I mean, your enemy eventually has to respond, right? If you have one catapult, it might take like 10 shots or something, or more than that, to destroy a barracks. But you know, eventually it will get those 10 shots, and then eventually it will get more. We'll destroy another barracks and other stuff, maybe. And I had the money, I had a CP, I was at 1000 CP, and my army was pretty strong in comparison to this, so I didn't really need to expand my main army much more. But yeah, I'm getting cavalry, this is more or less desperation, so like, maybe if I can make something happen with cavalry. At this fight, I don't know, I guess it doesn't look terribly, I'm not that far behind in CP. I have some spares, but he has Lords and Ukluk, which Lords and Ukluk alone is gonna just win this fight here. It's gonna just, not win this fight of alone, but like, it's gonna just ensure that this will definitely go my way, anyways. And the Rams are here, I mean at this point, yeah, that's very troubling, but also not really making any difference. So yeah. Could have done a bunch of different things here earlier. Of course, like, I could have also just played the early game better. That might have been made a difference here, right? If I couldn't even finish the game after the first base rush, or with the first base rush. If I didn't lose unnecessary units. If I didn't unnecessarily lose units, which are very little. Yeah, here's the outpost now, which I can't take as well. Now I'm slamming down my base. Getting outposts, getting Lindon maybe, also, right? Like, something against the crossbowmen. I mean, they're gonna get a sniper really easily, but if they have... But maybe they can, like, do stuff. I don't know. Curdon is also pretty good, I would say. I mean, Curdon has a really good buff, I think. And Glinnon and Sand are also pretty good, so it's like when you get Kurta and might as well get Glinnon's side. Oh yeah, that's all in the past now. I basically lost this one. It's a tournament. If this wasn't a tournament game, I probably would have been already surrendered here, but I thought maybe there's some hope. Maybe. I have to say, like, one thing, like, Fubuki definitely really, really nice that he... I mean, he has 900 CP. When he started walking over here, right, he had probably, like, 500 or something, or 600. But he knew that he was ahead enough, I guess, and that he had upgrades and the Lutz level, level 10, or level 10. So he just came here, got some rams, and is just attacking me now. Which is pretty nice here. Right, like, not letting me any chance to rebuild myself. Not much time. Is he here behind his build points? I think he might have actually. So I might be. No, I think it's no, he's not. I think it's even. It's getting a central spell because BM, I guess. I mean, yeah, clearly at this point, the mine would have been so much better because I mean the mine itself does actually pretty decent building damage, so. It's not an earthquake, but it's pretty decent. This was something where I waited for the walls to fall, so that I can maybe get a more effective army, Last Alliance army. Maybe could have been waited more, I mean it doesn't really matter if you lose a barracks, I could have just rebuilt it here. Just let him come in, like hey. But now, so that he has less chance to run away. Not that it really matters, I guess. He probably could have gotten a lot of it out of the way anyways. Here's Lufian, right, trying to get something happen, but even if you kill this entire army, like, there are three Orc Bergs, and that's alone, is gonna be able to stop me here. I think. So yeah, definitely interesting, right? Like, a lot of mistakes. And for my part, I didn't really focus on Fubuki, of course, so... Can't really say how well he played or what he could have done better. Not really interested in that one, I guess, in this case. And usually I'm right, usually I... because like the whole point of this watching this replay was like, what could have I done better? Answers a whole lot of things, right, really. Like, a lot of wrong decisions, a lot of just minor mistakes. But yeah, at this point, oh, it's over. Yeah, here I finally discovered the outpost. I mean, I already guessed that he had the outpost. I was like, yeah, okay, he most likely has this outpost now. Does he have the upper outpost? No. He doesn't really need to. Yeah, I think maybe it's also me, like, overestimating Isengard a little bit. It's hard. Just because, like, map control is less worth now, I guess, or because of inflation, I'm, like, generally less, among other things, right, I'm generally less capable of judging the position of my enemy. Because it's not like, okay, he has less map control, so I guess now I'm in a pretty good position, or he has more map control, so now I'm in a pretty bad position, it's like, yeah, okay. And it never was that simple, of course, but, like... map control is not as easy to as much of a factor as it used to be. And yeah, I'm just a bit out of my that's not as I don't experience right now. Yeah, there's nothing really interesting happening to this point. I mean, I have more CP, but not more CP. I have actually pretty decent CP compared to him. I mean. Considering that he was on my base already. But he has Saruman, yes. Oh, yeah, I guess this is why he got the thing for Saruman, maybe. Could have just gotten the mine. Maybe. I don't know. He has Lutz level 10. Right, that's Ugluk level 10. Those guys are monsters, absolute. Another fight here. Desperation, I guess. I'm like, hey, maybe with my spells. Yeah, I don't really have spells here. It's kind of relying on... Immortal Soldiers playing pretty decent and fighting. I mean, even if I didn't take this fight, right? I'm gonna soundly lose this fight. There are too many pikes here as well for the cavalry. So I guess carry against Immortals, maybe just not as useful when you're behind. Maybe only if you're if you're ahead and you actually can actually your mind force is gonna be scary enough to be an enemy. It's gonna use the berserkers here of the scout or what are they called? Cook scouts. Also really good of course. Get a carry. They were running for pikes now. And there you go. Oh, that's... Yeah. So yeah, I think that was a pretty interesting match to watch. I mean... Once again, right, this is like, I guess I underset my position. I took a good fight and was not happy with that. Whereas if I just gotten... Or a pretty decent fight at least, right? It could have been better. Also, I think in general, I think the base rush, the base rush was not a bad idea. But I guess you need armor, maybe. Maybe without armor, it's just a bad idea. Unless you can get it early enough, which on Morgai, it's probably not gonna get early enough, be early enough, so. Getting armor there, waiting for the armor, because obviously the very first base rush, which I totally forgot about, at the end of the game, did not work out at all. Just basically lost units there for no reason, for no reward. Right, and it's just, yeah. I mean, Immortals is not weak in late game as far as I don't know how strong Immortals is in late game, but I don't think it is that that weak. I think it's weaker than it actually is, or rather. Like, intuitively, I would say, like, okay, Immortals is probably not as strong in late game, but I think I'm actually wrong with that. just going from, like, other players' opinion there. Right, like, I mean, I could have, yeah, like, a lot of things I could have just done, right? Getting more cavalry, getting Curdan, getting Lindons, maybe. Or maybe even pressuring with catapults, which is risky, but possibly worth it. But yeah, I hope you enjoyed this video, of course. Maybe you learned something here. Maybe you learned something how to not be a bad Dine player. How to be better than me. I mean, that shouldn't be too hard, being better than me in Dine. And I hope you tune in next video, and until then, hope you have a nice time.